identity arises, sir, from the fact that it, from political problems and the history of the politics between the West and the Muslim world, we tend to forget in the West that the United States has more Muslim blood on its hands than Al-Qaeda has on its hands of innocent non-Muslims. You may remember that that the U.S.-led sanction against Iraq led to the death of over 500,000 Iraqi children. This has been documented by the United Nations. And when Madeleine Albright, who has become a friend of mine over the last couple of years, when she was Secretary of State and was asked whether this was worth it, said it was worth it. What complicates the discussion intra-Islamically is the fact that, the West has not been cognizant and has not addressed the issues of its own contribution to much injustice in the Arab and Muslim world. It's a difficult subject to discuss with Western audiences, but it's one that must be pointed out and must be raised. How many of you have seen the documentary Fahrenheit 9/11? The vast majority, but at least half here.
I've heard what I'm sure is nothing other than a rumor, something along the lines of that Muslim men are told things like, when you go to heaven, there'll be 1,000 virgins waiting for you. And that's why they're so, I mean, I think it stems from the belief that there's something in the Quran or something in Muslim religion or culture that makes them more willing to go off and commit, you know, be suicide bombers, or more willing to go off and fight in the holy war. I understood what you said about you think it was more driven by emotion than religion. I just wondered if there was anything at all. I certainly hear things like that and can't help but wonder if there's something about their religion or their culture that makes them more prepared to go off and die in the belief that they'll be closer to God, or that, you know, it's such an amazing act that's maybe different for Christians or people of other religions.
That's a very common question. In fact, just about 2 months ago, I was interviewed by Barbara Walters, who's doing a special on heaven, and she's interviewed suicide bombers who were expecting the embraces of 72 virgins in paradise, and she asked me, "Do women get the same privilege as well?" And I answered her, telling her, well, the Quran says, you shall have whatever your heart desires. In studies that have been made by political historians of terrorism, defined as militancy against non-combatants and civilians, the point has been made by political historians that terrorism has been done ever since the beginning of time, practically since the time of the Romans for sure, and they were really they were designed to achieve very specific target political objectives. And when we observe terrorism, whether it was done by the Tamil Tigers in Sri Lanka, or by Al-Qaeda, or whoever is behind the bombings in London or those in Madrid, we can see that they were targeted very target political objectives. Men, they're brutes, insensitive, etc., and you have the beginning of a gender conflict. If gender is not what distinguishes us, we'll look at skin coloring and say, ah, niggers or whiteys or whatever, then we created a gender, an ethnic conflict. Or we look